gears. You'll find them in your engines, in your transmissions, in your shop tools, in your toys. They're located in your garage, your shed, even your kitchen. But perhaps most importantly, you'll find them in your bicycles. Always remember, especially when driving your Prius, that the bicycle is the most efficient form of transportation that we have, fueled by simple things like Taco Bell and Mountain Dew. But anyway, let's learn physics. The basics, the most basics of gears, mechanical advantage, what's a torque multiplier, what's a speed multiplier. Two simple meshed gears. If the big one is the input driven by my hand and the small one is the output, this is clearly a speed multiplier because the output is moving faster than the input. Switch it up. The drive gear is the small one. The driven gear is the big one. It's moving slower, so this machine multiplies torque. When analyzing gears, first, just play with the system. Then, clearly identify which is the input, often called the drive, and which is the output, often called the driven. We'll need to calculate a ratio, and you can use either radius to radius, diameter to diameter, circumference to circumference, or, often very conveniently, the number of teeth to the number of teeth, because teeth represent circumference. So 36 teeth to 12 teeth, that little one is spinning 3 times as fast, 36 over 12. That's a mechanical advantage of 1/3. Here's a 36-tooth, 24-tooth combination, which means that the little one is spinning 1.5 times as fast, and the mechanical advantage is 2/3. Remember that any mechanical advantage less than 1 is a speed multiplier, and a mechanical advantage greater than 1 in these cases is a torque multiplier. Note also the change in direction. If one turns clockwise, the other one turns counterclockwise, always with these enmeshed gears. Switch the input and the output, and you now have a speed divider. But more importantly, because it divides speed, it multiplies torque. So the output torque is going to be larger than the input torque. Mechanical advantage in this case, 36 over 24, 1.5. Now we're back to that 36-12 combination. Switch the input and the output, and you now have a torque multiplier, clearly a speed divider identified visually, so it is a torque multiplier of 3. The mechanical advantage is 3. Note that a counterclockwise input gives you a clockwise output. It is still switching directions. So what do you do if you want to have them both spin in the same direction? One option is putting what we call an idler gear in between the two. You can see that both the input and the output are spinning clockwise, and the two shafts are now separated a larger distance. Now let's talk mechanical advantage and calculations. Watch the number of turns. Output turns 1, output turns 2, and output turns 3. We know that that's a speed multiplier, it's a torque divider, the mechanical advantage has to be less than 1, so it is 1/3. To get that value, the equation turns out to be the driven over the drive, the output over the input. And again, you can use circumference or diameter or the number of teeth or radius. And that idler gear, crazy thing, doesn't even matter what size it is, because if you watch the output, output travels 1 rotation, output travels 2 rotations, output travels 3 rotations for 1 input, just as what we had before. Mechanical advantage equation is driven over drive. We'll be using the number of teeth. So 12 teeth, 24 teeth, and 36 teeth is what we have. So that 3-gear combination is 12 over 24, and then 24 over 36. The 24s end up canceling out. That middle gear size does not matter. The idler size does not matter. Another example. This one is a torque multiplier because it's a speed divider. And it takes 1.5 turns input for 1 turn of the output. So the mechanical advantage is 1.5 or 3/2 or 1.5. In addition to using an idler gear, there's another method we can use to make sure that the input and output are spinning in the same direction, and that is use a belt drive or a chain drive. Not only do the pulleys turn in the same direction, the system, compared to the idler pulley system tends to be lighter, and you can place those shafts any distance apart as long as you have the proper length chain. Now let's find the mechanical advantage. First, you determine by looking at it whether or not it's a speed displacement multiplier or a force multiplier. Output of spinning faster must be a speed multiplier. Therefore, the mechanical advantage is less than 1. Then you spin and spin and spin and count the number of rotations. The input spins 11, output spins 14. Therefore, the mechanical advantage being less than 1 must be 11 over 14. In decimal form, that's about 0.79. Switch them, you get a torque multiplier, 14 over 11, or 1.27. One final example. This is called a worm gear, usually used for lifting heavy things. Just count input versus output. 1, 2, 3, and just keep on going. Notice that this definitely does divide speed. Therefore, being a speed divider, it is a torque multiplier, and if you counted all those, you get 20. Mechanical advantage is 20. So absent friction, that machine would take your puny little input torque and multiply by 20. Gears, the basics. You just learned physics.